Preparation of the model in Revit, definition of building cores and its shear walls. This video explains how to add and adjust building cores to a Revit model. The capacity of the cores can be checked afterwards in the SOFiSTiK structural desktop. In high-rise buildings, cores are for example staircases or elevator shafts. They are composed of shear walls forming complex sections, such as U-shaped or box-shaped, and repeating the same layout across levels. In the Revit model, the box-shaped walls on the west side of the building are a typical example of it. The color coding in the model displays changes in the thickness and or in the material properties of the walls. We define one building core for each group of wall. First, to facilitate the selection, we isolate all analytical walls of the model. Then, under Design Elements, we start the command Building Core and select the first group of walls corresponding to the first core. By clicking on Finish, the selection is validated. In the dialog, we can adjust the name of the new core. We call it Tier 1. This name is important because it allows to easily identify the core everywhere, in Revit, in the SOFiSTiK structural desktop, in SOFiSTiK graphic, etc. Additionally, the option Set all walls belonging to this core as shear walls allows to automatically categorize the wall instances selected into shear walls. Have a look at the previous video in this tutorial to know more about shear walls. We keep this option active and click on OK, so that the new building core is added to the model. It is of category generic models and has dedicated SOFiSTiK structural properties. There, we can check and adjust the name of the core, see its associated walls, and determine if the core should have a cross section or not. In this tutorial, we will need the cross section to check the capacity of the core in the SOFiSTiK structural desktop. So the property must be active. We can check and adjust the core cross section in the mapping table. Continue by repeating the process and adding two more cores covering the remaining levels. We call them Tier 2. And Tier 3 to 4. Now that the modeling of the core is finished, we can reset the isolation of the elements to display again the full model, including loads and boundary conditions. Clicking on Start in this view, we can access the dialog to generate a SOFiSTiK finite element model based on the Revit model. As building cores and shear walls are visible in the active view, they will also be generated in the SOFiSTiK model. The list tasks to be performed determine the scopes of this calculation. We keep them all active: generation of the finite element mesh, application of the loads, as well as analysis of the load cases. Clicking on Calculate starts the process. In the dialog, you can see the different tasks being performed. Now that the calculation is finished, you can display its results on the model. Click on Show Result to access them. Here, you can, for instance, display the finite element mesh, or the internal forces calculated for the building cores. and this for different load cases. By clicking on SSD, you can access the SOFiSTiK structural desktop to continue the workflow with the seismic analysis and the design of the different members. When accessing SSD for the first time, you can choose a template with predefined tasks to be faster. For this tutorial, we are using the template for seismic analysis. Of course, you can customize these templates to create your own, fitting perfectly to your company standards. Now, you know how to add building cores to your Revit model. You can open the SOFiSTiK structural desktop and continue there with the seismic analysis and performing of the check and design of these elements.